Hey guys, let's create a bicycle. We're going to start in the front view. Then we will bring in a reference image. Open up the side panel and then tap the photos icon. Then tap My Photos. Then tap Photos. Scroll until you find your photo. Photos are arranged by the date they are created. Once you find the image that you want, tap on it to load it into the side panel. Next, drag the image to the canvas. Just like that. We're going to use a reference image of the cross-section of a bicycle wheel we found on the web. Once on the canvas, you can position the image just a bit. Like that. Double tapping on the image treats it like a surface, meaning that you can move it and scale it just like other surfaces. In addition, we can change the opacity of the surface as well. With the image selected, tap on the color palette in the top menu and then adjust the opacity. Now it's time to sketch the cross-section of the bicycle wheel and tire. We'll make sure that the pen stroke is about 20 or so, then tap the pen tool in the top menu to change the stroke. Next, sketch some curves. We'll edit this curve a bit. Tap once on the curve to edit the control points, like that. Drag the control points around until you are happy with the curve. Tap and hold on the curve to add points. And you can also delete points by tapping and holding on the points and then tapping delete. Edit the curve to your liking by moving points, adding points, and deleting them as necessary. Make sure the endpoint in green is near the center of the cross section on the y-axis. So just keep editing the points. It's okay, take your time. Use the same method for the tire cross section. Sketch a curve, then edit the points. It looks like we need to put the reference image on a separate layer. Tap the side panel icon in the upper corner. Now go to the layers icon. Next, add a new layer by tapping on the plus icon in the upper corner. Tapping the small arrow in the side of the layer opens up more options. To assign the selected object reference image, tap Assign in the options. The reference image is now on its own layer. Tap the layer options again and then tap Lock. This will lock the layer. This prevents the layer from being accidentally changed. Let's create a new layer and assign the curves we just drew. The tire and wheel curves will be on their own layer now. Open up the layer, tap Assign. Make sure the endpoint of the tire curve is on the center y-axis as well. We will modify the tire curve just a bit. Again, add, delete, and move points to get the desired curve. When finished editing the curve, double tap in empty space or tap on the green check mark on the side to deselect the curve. Now it's time to mirror these curves. Double tap on each curve to select them, then tap Mirror function in the side panel. Select the y-axis, and we will now connect these curves. Turn Snap to Curves on in the Snap function in the lower corner. Double tap both the tire curves to select them, then tap Edit in the side menu. Use the Lasso tool to draw around the center points. This selects any overlapping control points. Tap and hold on the center point and tap Merge. Let's do the same for the wheel curves. In this case, we will connect the points before merging them. So you have the connect option there. Now we have created two symmetrical curves. Just making sure everything looks good. Now it's time to make the wheel and tire. Let's go to the front view. Select the curves and go to the side view. We're going to move these curves up just a little bit. Deselect the curves by double tapping in the empty space. Select the bottom curve, this will become the rim. Then tap Revolve. Two handles will appear at the ends of the curves. It looks like two dots. Grab and move these handles down to the x-axis, the bottom of the grid in this case. The line between these two points are the center axis of the revolved surface. You can now see the revolved surface. Tap the green check mark when done. Double tap the surface to change the color and opacity if you want. We're going to boost the opacity and make the color a little bit more silver. Let's repeat that process for the tire surface. Select the tire curve and then tap Revolve. Drag the handles of the revolve axis down. Tap the green check mark. And change the color. This is looking pretty good, but it's a bit small for a bicycle wheel. If we select and move the curves, we can change the size of the wheel. So just select those curves and then move them up. And that's looking pretty good. We have now made a bicycle rim and tire. We'll finish the wheel in the next part of this tutorial series.